You don't got any. You have any idea when? Oh, my Lord. Okay, then. All right, I appreciate it.
In Cock County, Tennessee.
No luck, puss.
Mark and Digger are reeling after a nationwide run on glass jars has left them high and dry.
The pandemic has apparently affected the jar business as well.
Where you found? You found some. Hey.
Yeah, I found them, $59 a dozen.
In the name of sense.
There's always, you know, an overstock of jars, and that's when you get your bargains. That's not the case anymore. People are buying things up just to have them, apparently.
This is insane. 12-pack, bottle, 32-ounce wide mouth, lid, $48.99.
I've already looked that place all over. We're just going to ride around and see if any of these little country stores anywhere's got any.
If we get a box here and a box there,
we may have to drive over another county.
Let's do it on the move. That won't hurt as bad as sitting here worrying about it.
You know, I've been doing this for probably a little over 35 years. I've never seen a jar shortage. We can't be in the liquor business if we don't have something to put a liquor in.
You ain't got no jars, have you?
No, we don't. Everyone is looking for jars.
I know.
There's none to be had. Everybody's manufacturing is at bottom levels right now.
We're wasting a lot of time. We could be making liquor.
And then we just have to leave it sitting in barrels. Or somebody bring you a jar and dip you some out.
We've always used jars in our world. That's the way we were brought up. In our neck of the woods, if we show up with a gallon milk jug of water, they'd run us out of town on a rail.
You ain't got to board jars, have you?
All we got is the little minis.
We got to find glass jars.
I hate to drive all over East Tennessee trying to find jars and just wasting gas.
Man, we ain't had to buy no jar in 2 months because we had enough.
We had enough.
We've made a lot of liquor this year. And what point do you stop manufacturing if you don't have no way to distribute? I mean, if you could protect...
We got old Killer Bees. Talk to us, Killer.
Hey, buddy, how you doing?
Killer Bees, he's bootlegging some for us. He has been on the hunt for jars as well. It serves him well as much as us.
I have found jars in Chattanooga.
Hot dog.
You can have them for free if you'll come get them. Y'all, this is great, except for one thing. 1,000 of the jars have mandarin oranges in them, and then the other 1,500 have expired mayonnaise in them.
You know, you don't want to look a gift horse in the mouth. It's free supplies.
All you got to do is pour the mayonnaise out. It'll pour out easy.
Oh, will it now?
Yeah. I can't imagine yet how much work it'll be to get them clean. What do you think, Buzz?
Well, we ain't got no choice. It's a better option than anything we got.
Honestly, we're at the point right now, Killer, we don't have no choice. Go ahead and commit us to them. What do you do with 1,500 jars of mayonnaise? Where do you even dump it out at?
Love you, mean it, guys.
All right. Love you more.
Thank you, Bees.
Well, that was a stroke of luck.
I'm telling you. I don't know, it might be. 1,500 jars of damn mayonnaise.
That's gonna be a mess to clean up.
Who would have ever thought you gotta go to Chattanooga to get a glass jar?
Well, if you don't find any place else, we're gonna be going to Arkansas or Iowa before long.
Bees didn't go into a lot of detail, did he?
No, because he probably don't know a lot of detail.
Killer Bees, he's found us 2,500 quart-sized jars. Bad news is they're full of expired mayonnaise and mandarin oranges. How nasty is that? I mean, I ain't worried about the oranges. They'll dump right out.
Yeah, I mean, mayonnaise, it's just gonna sit there and be
nasty.
Yeah, gooey.
You know, the upside is these jars are free.
We're living proof that the good Lord looks after some idiots, ain't we? Right.
Well, there she blows.
We get to the warehouse and, yep, there it is.
Extra light syrup, mandarin oranges. 1,008 jars. I know it's a win situation for the warehouse guy because he would have to pay money to dump this stuff out.
Yeah, you're good.
And we're hoping it's a win for us as well. We've done started thinking the mandarin oranges might ferment.
Yeah, that's a damn side of mash right there.
Thank you, man.
You're welcome.
We've committed to it now. Mayonnaise sure is a whirl.
It's plastic.
Oh, no. Are you me? We don't like plastic. You can clean glass really easy, but I don't know about this plastic.
Whoa! Damn!
I wouldn't want to eat it. Well, let's see what these other ones are.
The mandarin oranges, they're glass, but they're 20-ounce glass jars. You know, we always use mason jars, but that's not the case this time. Can't have a 32, you might as well get you a 20, and it's free.
The juice is good. They're okay.
Ain't a lot of sugar in it. They sugar.
Yeah,
I believe we can get that to ferment.
These jars present way more questions than they do solutions. Yeah, we can wash the jars, but what are we going to do with the mayonnaise?
You ever seen old Luther? He's a damn monster.
He's got a set of nuts like two footballs in a sack.
I'm telling you.
Our buddy Tater, he's got an old big hog named Luther.
Yeah, that's his barn right there, ain't it?
I believe it is.
I'm keeping my fingers crossed that Luther will eat the hell out of this mayonnaise, because if he will, we might have solved our problem with what to do with this mayonnaise.
But if he doesn't choose to go forward with it, I don't know what the answer is, but we gotta have jars immediately as our only cure.
Come here, little fella.
So we.
Where's my little pig at? Oh, he's lazy this morning.
Well, he ain't lazy. Hell, look what he's hauling.
Come on.
We need rid of this mayonnaise, and if old Luther takes a shine to it, hopefully Tater will take us up on this offer.
He needs a damn double tar wheelbar just to haul them nuts around in.
What are you doing there, Luther? Hell far, your ears would make a meal.
I got he's a man, ain't he?
Well, here we go. We're gonna see if he likes it.
Well, he's going for it before it gets in the trough. He'll eat that mud where it's at.
Yes, damn, it's Easter to him, ain't it?
Well, you know, I don't know much about facial expressions on pigs, but there ain't no doubt that what's going through Luther's face right now is pure joy.
I think he likes it, boy.
He ain't never had nothing like that before, has he? He'll chew his own damn ear off if he can get to it, wouldn't he?
Yeah, he's eating that, buddy.
Hey, Mark, while that mayonnaise got his attention, run back there and slap him in one of them big old nuts.
No.
I'll give you a dollar.
No.
I'll give you 10. I'll give you 20.
No, I might like it.
I guarantee you he won't.
He's gentle as a dog.
Hell, he's getting tired.
Have you ever got too much mayonnaise on a sandwich?
No. Hey,
how'd you like about 25 times more than what we got in that barrel down there?
Hell, I feed it to you.
The only hitch is it's still in jars.
It is.
Yeah. We don't want to see it go to waste. I mean, it'll fatten these hogs up like nobody's business.
Yeah.
But we need them cleaned up so we can reuse them jars. The second phase of our plan, that's talking Tater into cleaning these jars out. I believe that's going to help me and you both out.
I mean, if we can get them 8 or 10 cases at a time, that'll be good. Yeah. You know, you don't have to do them all at once just as you feed them to him.
Somebody don't want to overload him with it.
No. You don't want to give it to him every day.
No.
Well, he'll end up before he gets through eating.
He's probably eat them 7,000 calories there already, ain't he? Of course, he's a big boy. It takes a lot.
It's a hard job laying around sleeping all day. Everybody talks about a dog being lazy, but now, old pig be lazy too. Fine.
Yeah. Well, they ain't no reason for him to expend a lot of energy, are they? Well, all right, then. Old buddy, we're going to be able to hook you up.
He said, thank you, boys.
Your culinary track will thank us. We'll head on out and we'll show you where stuff's at, and you can get it as you need it. We stashed our trailer in a little old shed that we've got access to. We load old Tater up, show him where they're at.
Well, you can see here, brother, what we've got.
Good Lord.
You ever see so much damn mayonnaise in all your life?
Not never, ever.
Right here's what you're contending with, Tater, right there.
We didn't know what to do with it. You know how mountain people are. We don't like to waste nothing.
No, yeah. You don't waste nothing, period, do you?
I mean, I ain't gonna eat it, but.
Now, we're inclined to pay you a quarter a jar. How's that?
Nah.
I'm sold. Good with that.
That suit me just fine.
I'm really happy for me and Digger. I'm happy for Luther. I hope that don't put old Luther in hog heaven, literally.
No.
Now, them mandarin oranges, we're gonna try something with them. We're gonna hang on to them for the time being. If they don't work, you're welcome to take them. But if it does what we're wanting it to do, we'll take care of it.